I'm continuing my Olympic adventures. Yesterday I did sailing, and to complement that, today I'm learning how to fence, and I visited Catonsville to do that.
So it was for a long, long time an actual form of killing someone. So that's where we're starting from. We're trying to kill somebody.
Even so, Mike Oles assured me that fencing was one of the safest sports around.
And it's because so much care has been put into refining the weapons, refining the equipment, because we know that our tradition is trying to kill someone, so we want to protect against some accident, accidentally killing someone.
Fencers wear multiple layers designed to resist the force of a blade. The women even get to wear an extra layer of protection, which made me feel a little bashful.
Okay.
Okay, now.
No shame.
Next came the underarm protector, the pants, and then the fencing jacket.
One of the jokes about fencing jackets is that they're one buckle short of a straitjacket.
Indeed, I was already feeling a little crazy, especially when they gave me just one glove to wear and then asked me to place a cage over my head.
This takes a little bit to get used to.
Oh, no. Okay.
Okay, now you can see okay, right? You can see through there.
We practiced advancing forwards, then retreating backwards, and finally added the attacks.
That's it.
I also learned to defend.
Very good.
With my training complete, it was time to duel to the death. Okay, that's a little dramatic, but I did have to wear a special metallized jacket. Each time the opponent hit my jacket, it beeped to show that he scored. And 15-year-old Jacob Campitelli, a.k.a. Freckles, didn't hold back. Neither did my next opponent, 14-year-old Micah Wilson.
Hit him. Hit him. That's it. All right. It takes a little while to get used to it. Your training of culture says you're not supposed to hit somebody, right?
With a sword.
That's right. In this, you're supposed to hit somebody.
Rather than athleticism, a lot of fencing comes down to intelligence and instincts.
If you can outthink your opponent, even if they're younger and faster, you can still win.
A competitive drive helps as well.
To be a really good fencer, you have to love to win.
You also have to love hitting other people as well. And I have to say, that's one of the things that I really had to get over, the fact that I did have to lunge at someone with a sword. So a very neat sport. A lot goes into it, and you have to outthink your opponent, Tony. Something that I think women are pretty good at, they said.
Yeah, well, you know, speaking of women, you've inspired me to practice against Carlotta. She has her big hook that she uses to get us off the air when we're going too long. So I decided to grab the snow yardstick here that we use in the weather office. So I've been practicing fighting off Carlotta.
We're going to have to battle to the death when I get back to the studio.
You and I are going to go at it. But you can't use the meat hook that Carlotta has. You bet on Ava?
I bet on Ava.
I bet on Ava, too.